I'll start with a punchline. I have a problem with religion. I mean, with organized religion. The part that I hate is the sectarianism. Okay, that we're this and there's that. Like when I go to the synagogue, you know, those few precious times when I do go, it's always with the Jews and, you know, there's the non-Jews. No rabbi would ever say, well, Jews are better. Of course not. But still, it's very clear that there is us and there is them. And I understand we're the chosen people and there was persecution. And yes, there are anti-Semites, there are people who hate Jews and all of this kind of stuff. Still, the differences and sectarianism bother me. It's almost like we're Mac people and they're PC people. By the way, I'm not picking on Judaism. I think in general, organized religion can be pretty scary. I'll give you an example from my own life. I must have been 14 or 15 and I was with a group of friends, you know, back in Russia. And they said, let's go visit church. And I said, sounds good, let's go visit church. And so we went in. And up until that time, I had never been to a church. It was very beautiful. There was priests, there were parishioners, there were candles and everything. And then I remember, as I stood there, some old lady, God bless her, started screaming. He's a Jew, he's a Jew, he must leave. He must leave the church immediately. This is bad omen. And I will tell you, I was so taken aback because I thought, my God, maybe my presence indeed is really bad. So obviously I immediately left the premises. Why? Because one, I did not want the church to collapse. And more importantly, number two, I did not want to be disrespectful to another person's religion. And to set the record straight, I was not bitter then and I'm not bitter now. This poor lady, she must have been a product of this very sectarianism that I hate so much and I'm trying to denounce. By the way, most major religions, one way or another, you know, overtly or covertly, at the very least, hint at the transmigration of souls. In the Hindu and Buddhist traditions, they just come out and say, and they talk about reincarnation. And in Christianity and Judaism, at least based on what I've read, you also can see hints of transmigration of souls. Like in the Ashkenazi Jewish tradition, they never call a child by the name of a living relative. Like, I bet you have never heard of Mr. Mordechai Goldberg Jr., right? The reason for this is not just because they want to commemorate the name of a relative who passed on, it is because they believe it's the soul of that very relative that comes to your family. Why am I even talking about this? Am I a rabbi? Am I a spiritual leader? No, not at all. But still, every religion says we are a soul and we get a body. And this whole transmigration, that means we get multiple bodies. And I think it's the bodies that have the nationality or religion, not the souls. So in one life you could be a Jew, in another life you could be, I don't know, a Wehrmacht officer and everything in between. Being so hung up on what nationality you are, what religion you are, is not at all spiritual. It's not even philosophically smart. Anyway, all of this brings me to the following conclusion. Being a part of religion is good, but at some point you want to transcend that and become spiritual. At the very least, you want to be very tolerant to other religions. Don't believe in this whole sectarianism. Anyhow, this is Crazy Russian Dad. I hope God did not hear much of what I said. Thank you and good night.